Says Life magazine, True Grit is good enough for me. It's good enough for you. And if it isn't good enough for some movie company, then the free enterprise system is really going to hell. Move along!
They tell me you're a man with True Grit.
Well, what do you want? Speak up.
I've already wrinkled the paper. It's pretty loose because your makings are too dry. I'm looking for Tom Chaney.
Well, who's he?
He's the man that shot and killed my father, Frank Ross.
Says the New York Times, as touching as it is irreverently amusing.
Marshal Rooster Cogburn and I are going after the murderer, Tom Chaney.
How did you light on that greasy vagabond?
They say he has grit.
He's a notorious thumper. He's not a man I would care to share a bed with.
Nor would I.
And now, Paramount Pictures presents the Hal Wallace production, True Grit. Starring John Wayne as Rooster Cogburn, the most colorful character he's ever played.
If I smelled as bad as you, I wouldn't live near people.
Kim Darby as Matty Ross.
My God, she reminds me of me.
Glenn Campbell in his first big screen role.
A little earlier, I gave some thought to stealing a kiss from you, although you are very young. And you're unattractive to boot. But now I'm of a mind to give you five or six good licks with my belt.
Well, one would be as unpleasant as the other.
True Grit, a slip of a girl, a pot-bellied, one-eyed Western Marshal, and a Texas Ranger wearing breeches a size too big.
What are you doing?
Looking for sign.
You couldn't see it if you saw it.
They're trailing the most surprised killer the West ever knew.
I'm here to take you back to Fort Smith and hang you.
And I think I will not go. Now, how do you like that?
Now, you mean to say that you won't go with me on your own free will?
You just got it the other way around. Now, you will follow me. I didn't think you'd do it.
Says Saturday Review, True Grit is lively, uproarious, high adventure.
I mean to kill you in 1 minute, Ned, or see you hanged in Fort Smith at Judge Parker's convenience. Which will it be?
I call that bold talk for a one-eyed fat man.
Cogburn, not much.
Look, Hathaway was a real talent, and like most of these legendary directors who gave us these Hallmark pictures capturing the Wild West, they were seen as some tough personalities. The thing about Wayne is Wayne brought Wayne, no matter who was directing, right? Wayne seemed to be comfortable with anyone in the director's chair because, you know, John Wayne was a titan. He's going to get the job done no matter who's screaming and yelling. But I have a feeling that Wayne probably to some degree would keep the peace on a set. But in terms of Hathaway, talking about True Grit, right? That's where Wayne got the Oscar. And I would argue that Wayne deserved it earlier than True Grit.
Oh, yeah. I thought his performance in that was a bit of a caricature. And I think they said, oh, God, the guys, look at his career. I mean, the films he's done, let's give him, It's almost like an honorary Oscar. But I mean, you look at films, well, The Searchers.
Yeah, for sure.
Another one, huh? Give me a hand, Charlie.
This has come a long way before he died, Captain.
Well, Ethan, there's another one you can score up for your brother.
I don't like it.
What don't you like?
Injuns on a raid generally hide their dead. And if they don't care anything about us knowing, it only spells one thing. They ain't afeard of us following or of us catching up with him either.
You can back out any time you want, Nesby.
Ethan, I didn't say that. Didn't say such.
Easy, Nesby, easy. Jorgensen!
Why don't you finish the job?
What good did that do you?
By what you preach, none. But what that Comanche believes, ain't got no eyes, he can't enter the spirit land. Has to wander forever between the winds. You get it, Reverend. Come on, boy.
Magnificent performance on there.
I would say The Searchers or Liberty Valance. I think both should have been considered. I mean, the Academy does do that, though, as we all know. They get to a point where they feel like they've missed it with a Titan, or they did it with Peter O'Toole, too, you know, and they circle back and they make sure they honor him later, which I guess better late than never, right?
Yeah.
I would also say They Were Expendable was one of Wayne's better performances, too, you know, as sort of the undercard. Trying to actually do the right. I mean, anyway, so Hathaway's got him on True Grit. And I look at that movie to this day, and obviously the Coen brothers remade it. They had a huge passion for the book and for the earlier film. And I think personally, it's like, that's one of those movies at any point in time you can watch and you cannot turn it off if it comes on.
No, it's highly entertaining. And Hathaway's films were invariably like that. I mean, they're just good, solid stories. I know, and True Grit, it's the story is, John Wayne said, I'm not wearing a goddamn patch. Forget it. You know, I'm John Wayne. I'm done going around with an eye patch. And Hathaway told us that they go into the wardrobe department, pick out stuff, and two or three times, and Hathaway would always bring out the patch. He said, for God's sakes, just try it. And Wayne tried it, and they did it with the fine mesh so that he could actually see out. He could see, it was a partial patch, but he could see out through the patch. He said, oh, this isn't bad. So it was basically Hathaway that kowtowed into wearing the patch. And I'm sure that, I'm sure he gave shit to Wayne. So wear the goddamn patch, will you? You know, you're fat, you're old, and now you get one eye. And, you know, he probably said, you'll probably win an award for this one, for Christ's sake. Just put it on.
And the story goes, after the Oscars, every crew member had a patch on the next day of the movie they were working. Look, the patch is a great touch. I think that's I think you can really find the character with elements like that. And Wayne, to his credit, he played it the way straightforward disaster. Like, he played it like a train wreck. And I think he deserves a lot of credit for that. And it's what's the line from the movie where he's like, I want to ask you what your intentions are. And he goes, I mean to kill you today.
Farrell, you and your brother stand clear. I got no interest in you today. Stand clear and you won't get hurt.
What's your intention? Do you think one on four is a dog fall?
I mean to kill you in 1 minute, Ned, or see you hanged in Fort Smith at Judge Parker's convenience. Which will it be?
I call that bold talk for a one-eyed fat man.
Fill your hand, you son of a bitch!
They're too far and they're moving too fast.
No grit, Rooster Cogburn. Not much.
stir. I'm shot to pieces.
Hooray for the man from Texas!
Loaded with great lines, yeah.
Your road to redemption is paved with tombstones. No quarter, kill all masters. Go to noquarterkillallmasters.com. Rated R.